Hello. It is really strange for me to make the opening speech of an artistic freedom of expression event as an artist who had to leave my country because of the lack of artistic freedom of expression. I had to leave Turkey because of a vicious and sustained campaign against me and my friends on social media and TV, in which we were subject to to a continuous barrage of brutal verbal abuse and rape and death threats. The attacks were fronted by Turkish politics who accused me and the people behind the production of my play Me Minor of being the architects of the Gezi Park demonstration in June 2013. I have a strange relationship with Wales. Actually, people find it strange. I find it very natural. I wanted to live here since I came for the first time 10 years ago. Now it has been almost 1.5 years since I started living here. I feel safe. More importantly, I feel home. When I was asked to make the opening speech, I started thinking how I could reflect on artistic freedom of expression in Wales. I have had some solid observation and personal experience about the issue since I started living here, and I have to say, not all favorable. At first, it was strange for me to express myself without being offensive. Then, when I went through the Art Freedom Wales online conversation, which is informed today's agenda, I realized that one of the prominent issues raised in the conversation was causing offense, not only to the public, but also within the artistic world. So I stopped worrying about being offensive, and I decided to express my thoughts as they are. Here we go. Almost everyone I met since I started living here said how direct I was when speaking my mind. I couldn't fully understand this at first. After all, I wasn't even able to my truly sharp tongue self, as English is still a struggle for me to speak, but let me do my best. I write articles for various websites around the world. They reach a global audience and receive different reactions each time. However, the reactions from the people I know in Britain have always been the same. They always criticize me for being very direct, and I was always warned that I could cause offense to the readers. At first, I thought this was because of translation issues. Then I started to realize that this was not about the translation, but about how British people choose to use the language and how language defines people's thought patterns. And as far as I have observed here, these thought patterns impose restrictions to being direct and indeed truthful. For some, it seems important to fit in and be part of a liberal consensus and self-regarding radical community. For me, I need to point out complacency and the fact that too much that is presented as radical is not. On the contrary, too often what I have seen is a safe, watered-down effort to appease all and offend no one. I know that one of the main points of this event is to show how important it is to embrace works that many cause offense which create controversy. I also know that the right to offend is really a concern among the artistic world. Yet, what I gather from the comments about my book and the daily conversation, debates, talk, and speeches I have joined or listened to is that being offensive is a very big concern in this country and has a depilating impact even in artistic circles. And as someone who has grown up outside of this culture, I see this as a massive barrier. I believe it makes people tiptoe around issues rather than actually engaging with them. As long as we have this concern about being offensive in almost every aspect of life, how can we demand the right to offend in artistic productions? This obsession about causing offense also means not being open to criticism. How can we create freely or develop ideas when words like interesting are used about works you don't actually like? Why are people so open to being offended? Why are they so fragile here? Maybe this can be a question to discuss. I had another observation I wouldn't expect to see, at least in artistic circles, that Orientalism is still relevant. It was sad for me to see that a format latent Orientalism, a concept which I would like to borrow from Edward Said, a concept still exists. I express feeling like pain or rage in my work. The reaction I receive here most of the time is that things expressed in my work are about the place I come from, which is the Orient. Or the reaction I got to my work in Turkey could only happen in Turkey, because here in the Occident it is different. Whenever I try to make point about the universal relevance of the expression in my work, I often get a response that they are not comparable with the situation here and that it is not right to say that they are alike. So, how come girls are called child brides when they are married at the age of 15 in the Orient, but young mom when they do so in the Occident? Or honor killing for the place and crime of passion for another? It hurts the same everywhere in the world when one is slapped in the face. 10 years ago, when I was awarded the Freedom of Thought Award in Turkey, I said that freedom of expression is not enough, and then we must free our minds from forced patterns of thought. And 10 years later, I am saying the same sentences here. For me, the main problem in the world we live in, be it in Turkey or in Wales, the so-called Orient or so-called Occident, the problem is the same. And now I am going to use a word that will let you put me in a box and ignore this problem if you choose to. Yes, the problem is created through educational and familial systems over thousands of years of patriarchy. The problem is caused by self-censorship due to perception we develop from the controlled and limited information that has been presented to us. And risk occurs when art starts to question the state, the country, the social organism, and the household structure, all of which are the representations of this persistent thousands of years old patriarchy. When an audience perceives the fears and the traumas imposed on women and men by religions and ideologies, the risk in a work of art is heightened. If the work of arts make its audience realize why and whose sake women and men had to give up the naturalness of their bodies, then the risk becomes truly risky. And this is valid all around the world. What has to be understood is that when a work of art, this is implicitly risky, has been truly perceived, the resulting awareness cannot be annihilated by any means, prohibition, censorship, or by neglect. I believe if female and male artists are able to create works of art originating from their own existences, then those works of art define what risk is and what is risky. I was accused of being witch. My book was banned, I faced media embargo, And at the end, I was forced to leave my country because of fearlessly expressing my thought and always holding my ground. There is a saying in Turkish, speak the truth and you will get ostracized from 9 villages. Wales is my 10th village and I hope it will be the last. Thank you very much.